From the University of Minnesota School of Music, my name is John Leonard, and I'm here to provide you with a two-minute tip on training your young musicians on better intonation, both in and out of the ensemble setting. Here are the top five things I consider when dealing with intonation. Number one, individual responsibility. The first thing that needs to be addressed is the individual responsibilities of each player. I have encountered many players in my bands over the years who could play a tuning pitch, it's 10 cents sharp on the tuner, I ask them to pull out, they play it again, and now it's 20 cents sharp. So the first thing I stress with players is that we can't progress until they can play their instrument consistently. They have to be able to play a note, register where it lies on the tuner, take the instrument off their face, relax everything, start over, and after repeating the process a dozen times, average the same pitch placement on the tuner each time. Number two, tuning technique. When I first introduced the concept of group tuning, I stressed the following three things. Number one, play with your best posture. Number two, play with your body fully relaxed. Number three, play straight through the instrument to get your best tone possible. Additionally, you shouldn't allow the student to look at the tuner at the beginning of the note. Some students will look at the tuner and do something with their body or embouchure that will alter the three rules I stressed above. You play with your best posture, fully relaxed, best tone, and the pitch is the pitch, and then you adjust the instrument. And if we've built up the consistency from my earlier point about individual responsibility, then students will be able to tune quickly and effectively every time. Number three, know your instrument. Each student needs to know the tuning tendencies of their instrument. As your players continue to progress, knowing the tuning tendencies of their specific instrument will become more and more important. Perhaps, as a performance assessment, you could have them fill out an intonation worksheet. It could be for the full chromatic range of their instrument, but it could also be much more targeted, such as just the notes within a certain major scale. Have them fill it out marking how, on average, when their tuning note is in tune, this note is 5 cents sharp, that note is good, this note is 2 cents flat, etc. It will get them closer and closer to gaining a full understanding of this concept that will in fact take years and years to master. Number four, show your values. Show the students that you value intonation by tuning at the start of every rehearsal, if not more often, such as before each piece or large rehearsal segment. And if the sounds are not to your liking, tune again. Let them know it's not just a thing you're doing, but that it matters and that you're listening. I have clinic bands at festivals before that were co-taught by two directors, where the students played in tune for one director and then not in tune for the other. And I discovered in conversations after the fact that one of the directors made it a focus of their rehearsal and the other did not. So students have a choice when they're working for you about what percentage of their brain power they will give to intonation. And as important as notes and rhythms and style are, if your values are that intonation be at least 1% a bigger piece of the pie than anything else, you have to let them know it. Number five, equal and just intonation. An important concept of intonation in the band is understanding the difference between equal and just intonation. Equal intonation being the type of intonation used with pianos or keyboard percussion instruments, and just intonation being the kind of intonation that winds and choirs use to achieve greater chord resonance by adjusting pitches slightly sharp or flat. The most common examples of adjusting for just intonation would be asking the players of the third in a major chord to play 14 cents flat, or the players of the third in a minor chord to play 16 cents sharp, but it can and does go much deeper than that. This is where your work as a diligent conductor and preparer of your scores comes in. Our system of music notation does not inform the players what chord quality they are playing. Only their ears or your instruction can do that. However, giving instructions about playing a note a little bit flat or sharp really will not work effectively unless some of my earlier points about individual responsibility have been addressed first. If the trumpets are playing a note that is notoriously sharp on their instrument, but now it's the minor third, they don't need the instruction about bringing it up 16 cents. They just need to know not to do the adjustments they often have to do to get it straight up and down on the tuner. An important thing to remind them, and I can't claim this as my saying, so feel free to steal it yourself, is you are never in tune, you are always tuning. I hope these ideas help reinforce concepts you are already familiar with or offer some new perspectives. Please reach out to me if you have any questions about this video or anything else I can help you with. If you have a tip or trick that you like to use with your ensembles to help with intonation, please leave it in the comment section below. I look forward to hearing from you. I wish you all the best in your music making and discovery. Thanks for watching.